I'm so happy I'm still alive.
Antonio Plaza Orozco cries just thinking about being one of these men. Freed hostages returning home after being held at sea. Orozco was working as a senior crewman off the coast of West Africa last year aboard this ship. Pirates cut through the barbed wire. On the deck, they beat him bloody with their AK-47s.
He told, "I will cut your neck and I will throw you overboard."
Did you think he was going to kill you?
Yeah. They are crazy. Crazy, very crazy.
An 11-day ordeal that found Orozco negotiating for his life and the life of his crew.
I make friends with them, and I told them, please, my brother, don't kill us.
Befriending your pirate, something he learned in this anti-piracy class, a government-mandated course for these Filipinos who work at sea, because so many of them are at risk of becoming hostages.
One-third of all seafarers, the people who work on international waters, are Filipino. The reason why? The money. In just 1 month, they can earn $1,500, an unimaginable income, in a country where 40% of the people live on less than $2 a day.
There is no other option, says Ray Domingo Nuval, who was held hostage with Orozco.
Why would you even consider going back?
On the ship? Because I have to support my family, so I have to go back.
I have one son still in school. I am the one who sent him to the school. That's why I sacrificed.
It's an unfair sacrifice, says the country's second biggest seafarers union. The government's anti-piracy training is something, but
I think that is not the solution.
The union says what's really needed is more than exercises and classroom simulations. It would like a naval escort or private armed security on board, both options the government says it's weighing. What's not an option is stopping the work of the seafarers, something on which all sides, even these former hostages, agree. Orozco and the rest of the crew are alive because the pirates simply decided to take the cargo and go.
That's life.
A dangerous life that Orozco will continue when he returns to the job this week, joining hundreds of thousands of Filipinos already at sea. Hyung Law, CNN, Manila.